Welcome, everyone. Today, I'm really excited to have our guest, Antonio Lignon, who is the Director of Engineering for relayr. Antonio, we're really happy to have you with us today, and I'm sure this is going to be a fun conversation.
Thanks, Chase. It's great to be here to talk about relayr and how excited we are about being a Microsoft partner.
And that's great, Antonio. We're actually really excited to have you as a partner as well. I'm anxious to dive in. So let's talk about relayr's journey.
Yeah. So relayr is at the core of building a data platform and data-driven products. The platform is serving as a foundation for the development of products and professional services that enable vertical value integration. We offer robust interoperability capabilities to allow us to engage OEMs of different maturity levels. Currently, our technology drives unique guarantees with associated insured offers like uptime warranty, warranty about on-plane repairments, if the asset uses our product, etc. So with this in mind, we developed two unique products, Skylar and France.
Well, those are certainly very unique names for products, but let's talk about what makes the products Skylar and France so unique in and of themselves.
Sure. So Skylar unifies the components of a rotating equipment setup, such as pumps, motors, generators, or any other piece of rotating machinery to reveal powerful insights that are put back into improving performance. So the solution reveals undiscovered opportunities to improve efficiencies and to minimize downtimes, providing a decisive market advantage. France, on the other hand, improves the operational efficiency of elevators by reducing the amount of maintenance visits with remote diagnostics, shortens the troubleshooting time with root cause analysis, and makes on-site visits planable and sustainable by reacting to wearing and tearing before it escalates into issues leading to downtime. So both of our products open new revenue streams by predicting failures before they occur, boosting customer satisfaction and lowering risk with guaranteed outcomes, thereby offering clients new services options for their own clients as well.
That's fantastic. Those really are some tremendous benefits for customers. Help us understand how customers actually interact with your solution.
Sure. So I think in this case, the users does not interact directly with infrastructure. Rather, users interact with domain-specific products that the platform powers. These products are focused on addressing well-defined value pools in well-defined customer segments and markets. So they complement our professional services offering as well as third-party software that we orchestrate. This ultimately creates a well-rounded offer with a high degree of repeatability for us. So actually, let me show you how our customers experience France and Skylar now. So with Skylar, we deliver value by delivering two value pools, minimizing unplanned downtime and reducing maintenance costs. Skylar minimizes unplanned downtime by providing asset condition monitoring, anomaly detection with user notifications, and root cause analysis with actionable insights. We reduce the maintenance cost of our business partners and end customers by optimizing the reliability and maintenance services, reducing catastrophic failure repairment costs, and therefore production losses, and by stocking the right number of spares just for in-time needs. So what you see here is actually how a technician would actually spend the morning having a cup of coffee ready and just doing a morning check of all the asset deploys in my customer locations. So I can see the status of the assets that I have deployed. I can see also this list filtered by facility, by customer, by region. So let's double click and let's just inspect one facility. So in this facility, I can actually see where the asset is deployed. So I can check also in every floor plan where my assets are located, which is really important because we can actually guide on-site crews and maintenance services teams and guide them into where to find the specific asset. So it seems in this case, we have a transferred pump AC motor. So let's take a look. So here I can see the location of the asset. I can see where all the relayr sensors are placed and on which component of the asset the sensors are installed. So I can see that we have a drive end bearing, the non-drive end bearing, and the pump. I can see that there has been some changes in its history. So As we enable almost 24/7 real-time continuous monitoring and data acquisition, as opposed to manual on-site data collection, there is plenty of information available to a trained technician or vibration analyst to figure it out. So let's take a look. So the vibration analyst can inspect the existing data and dive deeper to get more details and download if necessary. So they can create reports out of this data for further evaluation and diagnosis. So in this view, a technician can inspect the status and histories of different variables and readings and display accordingly to ISO format as expected in the field. So our partners can specify, in this case, how to know when a given asset is degraded, so they can monitor against the current status. And if we want to deep dive into it, we can inspect the data in more detail, or as I mentioned before, download for further analysis. So we can review, we can zoom in, and if at some point we need to have more context about what has happened before, if what happened the previous servicing of the asset, or if there is any pre-existing conditioning, we can go to the maintenance record. We can check what has happened with this asset since the last maintenance or since the last annotation issue. We can also add a new record if there is something that we want to comment or we want to add here for tracking purposes. And of course, we can also go here to the analysis tab. So we can also see here basically what's going on with the asset and what are the things that we need to consider for the future. So most importantly, we can also scale the learnings of our system. So through the usage of an artificial intelligence, the platform also allows the technicians to leverage machine learning anomaly detections to enable also AI-based detectability and actionable asset insights. So all of this combined allows our users and our customers to plan and coordinate maintenance operations before a costly emergency occurs, therefore decreasing unplanned asset downtime and reducing maintenance costs. So as mentioned before, France delivers value to our customers by improving the elevator's operational efficiency. We do this by reducing the maintenance efforts and cost, meanwhile, enabling new revenue with independent and integrated technology. As we did in our previous demo, we will experience France through the day of a dispatcher, that is, the person responsible for receiving the maintenance calls from customers, triaging these issues, and then dispatching the technicians on site. So as a dispatcher, I normally start my day having a cup of coffee, planning the maintenance schedule. So France allows me to easily visualize all the devices in my portfolio. So I can check in the status overview, which devices have been reporting to me, which devices I know they have some issues, and then I'm on top of things that needs to be done. So we can diagnose and we can service in advance. So I can see also from my fleet of devices which elevators we have. So let's click one here so we can actually have a better insight of what France can do for me. So in this case, I know that there is a breakdown. I know the elevator status. I know that there is a breakdown related to door cycling. So I already can infer what may be the issues that we need to support and we need to address on site. I can also have useful KPIs like the door time, total mileage. I know when was the last maintenance and how many trips the elevator has had since. So this gives me a more complete information into actually how we can better address this issue and be more effective. If I click here on inspect, France actually gives me root cause analysis and insights. So I can plan ahead what will be the possible solutions on this on site, what will be the tools or maybe the spare parts that I need to bring with me. And I can actually see here more statistics, which will help me to do the best diagnosis on time. So I will spend less time on site doing the repairman work, but also I will be doing less trips on site because I have all the information I need here to prepare. In this case also, I can basically reassign a technician So I know that Jenny will be closer to the site location, and he will have all these new insights of how he can address this topic. So then I can see here the status of the services. So I can see here from the moment he's assigned, by the moment he acknowledges and he's on his way to the location, when he's on site, so we can provide him more support. And then I will know when the task is completed, so I can report back to our customers and to basically my management team. So as a dispatcher, France allows me to support technicians. Technicians are my most valuable assets, with the right tools and the right insights, therefore helping them to improve and to become more efficient. On the other hand, we support facility managers to enable new revenue by providing them with white label customer portals, as we showed before, advising them based on the collected data on how they can modernize and how they can optimize the fleet and the portfolio, helping them with compliance, reporting on their assets to ensure that they run a successful operations.
That's a really cool demo, Antonio. Thanks for sharing that with us. You know, a key point in your technical strategy until recently seemed to be kind of developing a vendor agnostic middleware layer. Why did you choose to go all in with Microsoft? I'm curious.
Yeah, so actually Microsoft has a very strong standing in the market. So both from the technical perspective, but also from a trust perspective, which is important in our business. Microsoft can bring the right services to the table to help us to make our vision a reality. So we believe that OEMs and MROs need to transform into service-driven solutions that integrate vertically to stay competitive. So for us, enablement has been a strong technical component, but also requires us to move up the stack and shift our attention to data-driven products for specific domains. We also shifted our low-level infrastructure functionality to a hyperscaler to enable a higher horizontal scalability and to increase the performance, throughput, and availability of our platform. So for this, the strong cooperation with the Microsoft product departments and development teams has reinforced the decision for us.
That's fantastic. Thank you for sharing that. And I'm sure other partners find that super useful as well. Azure is a very robust platform. Lots of services. I'm curious, which Azure services are the most relevant for you and your solution?
Yeah, so given the focus we have on data-driven products, end-to-end operational of artificial intelligence, and being able to execute models against complex environments, this has been the key. So we are focusing heavily on services to manage AI model lifecycle and pre-processing data. Time series insights, Databricks, MLOps, just to name a few. Our next areas of focus are digital twins. The data model, actor, and complex interactions in equipment as a service settings are actually a great fit for the digital twin modeling capabilities. Lastly, onboarding assets and communications continue to be of interest for OEMs that are not digitally mature yet. So this is where we are leveraging IoT Hub and DPS. I will say that probably also other honorable mentions are Active Directory, of course, EvenHub, and also EvenGrid. And I think this has like a twofold. Domain-driven architecture allows us to have a clear separation between what we consider to be core capabilities and what we consider to be a specific domain functionality for products. So ultimately, our goal is to equip teams to execute fast, to develop data-driven products with a rich foundation of functionality, autonomous with governed execution, and also robust policies and processes to ensure consistency. And ultimately, our platform is becoming a great mix between Microsoft Azure services and relayr custom services with a very heavier weight towards the latter in the product domain. So given there is a high degree of domain-specific logic required on that end, we are exploring things to simplify your setup through functions, offloading as much as work as possible to the underlying platform, so we can focus on solving problems that matter the most for our customers.
Yeah, you know, speaking of solving those problems for customers, what are the kind of enablers or the key enablers of your equipment as a service model here?
Well, so equipment as a service needs financing and insurance in addition to technology. Relayr creates Microsoft power technology in close alignment with the right insurance and financing offers. So that's the differentiation. Equipment as a service, as we believe, has three technical components broadly. A data platform that can establish connectivity to the assets and collect the relevant telemetry, value-add services, and operational stack. The latter is not something that we develop within relayr, but actually we're collaborating with Minitree as our parent company, because as we have to accommodate a wide breadth of technical sophistication, the data platform needs to support both shallow data acquisition through normally cloud-to-cloud integration, but as well as deep data acquisition through edge services and infrastructure that we're building. So the value-add services are built on top of the platform. Here we differentiate between our source data that is normally stored in a global data lake and higher-level solution data that is stored on hot storage databases. The approach here is akin to the emerging trends of data meshes, where different teams can actually extract and transform data from the platform and tailor it to suit their needs. Lastly, so enabling the operational part of equipment as a service requires us to have a very robust interoperability capabilities with third party system. As an example, to manage asset life cycles, to provide the relevant data and contextual information, to issue invoices, warranties, and so on and so forth.
Yeah, it's a fascinating business model, and that relationship with Munich RE allows you to do some just amazing things. It's very innovative. And having a solution that's already innovative and kind of ahead of the curve, what do you see beyond that? What do you see on the horizon? What's next for you?
Well, in the IoT platform field, we will likely see a consolidation and a continued migration up the stack, focusing on more and more on vertical solutions and leveraging horizontal platforms from hyperscalers. I think in a broader sense in the space, we expect to see more interest towards remote collaboration, like augmented reality, virtual reality, and the maturing of artificial intelligence solutions, moving to actual true production grade setups.
Oh, that's great. I'm gonna ask you a question that I like to ask a lot of our partners. So having seen some success, what advice would you give to the next generation of future developers around adopting PaaS-based services?
Oh, well, just don't spend too much time reading documentation and preparing for what you don't know. Spend this time rather building, failing, and learning. Grow knowledge and expertise in your teams. Whenever you are stuck, just reach out to Microsoft. We have a great collaboration so far with them. Be proactive also about product feedback. Don't attempt to replace your infrastructure one-to-one with Azure services. So make sure that you benefit from the opportunity to redesign and re-architect your systems and to move towards simpler designs.
Okay, that's some great advice. Antonio, you have shared with us some excellent information. Again, really appreciate the demo. Truly been a pleasure to understand more about the relayr solution. And it's been amazing working with you and your team, and really happy to see the progress you're making in our IoT ecosystem jointly. So thank you.
Oh, thank you for the invitation, Chase. It has been great talking to you. I really enjoy your conversation, giving the chance to share our journey with Microsoft and how we are helping our business partners and their end customers to stay relevant.